Hopefully everyone's having a great morning, afternoon, or evening so far. My name is EQ, and welcome to the Stonkaholic Space Station. On this episode, we're going to be talking about a multi-chain project. If you follow any of my live streams, you know that I'm obsessed with these chain-agnostic projects, and I think there's a lot of upside potential into the 10, 20, 30-year plan on these projects. But before we talk about the super gem with a $33 million market cap, if you could take a second to throw a like on this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, go check out our Crypto Accelerator program and our Crypto Discord. That'd be greatly, greatly appreciated. And without further ado, let's get this intro. So Rubic or RBC is currently sitting at 3 cents per token. It's ranked 698th on CoinMarketCap. We're sitting at a $33 million market cap. So this project is insanely, insanely low. It has a total supply and a max supply of 104 million. There is 109 million currently in circulation, which is 88% of their total supply. So it's finite, it's deflationary. They've already gone through the CERTIC audit. They are built on Ethereum, the Binance Smart Chain, and Polygon. So let's get into a little what Rubic actually offers. Now, before we were talking about aggregators on exchanges, now we're talking about multi-chain swaps, which is next level. It's a protocol that allows you to swap any of 10,500 plus tokens on the network and between 9 blockchains in one click. So as you can see from this video, you can choose from Avax and Moonbeam or Moonriver. You can choose from Solana. You can choose from Polygon. You can choose from Matic. The possibilities are endless with a project like this, and the fact that you can just swap cross-chain is incredible. This is what chain agnostic looks like, and this is what the future of crypto is going to be. We talk about everyone building these vertical towers, and eventually we're going to have to build horizontally and build multi-chain and cross-agnostic so all these wonderful layer ones and zeros can communicate with each other. So your 9 blockchains that they're working with right now are Ethereum, BSC, Polygon, XDAI, Harmony, Avax, Moonriver, Fantom, and Solana. And it also includes 60 plus decentralized exchanges within that, so it's a massive aggregator. Their staking will be coming very soon with a high APR of 80%. That's going to be right off the bat, so don't expect that a couple years in. You'll be able to earn your rewards in BRBC, which is going to be their utility token. And you have team buyback, so 0.5% of fee from multi-chain volume will be used to buy back and distribute RBC to the reward pool. Now, they've won multiple grants from major ecosystems like Polygon, Harmony, and Near. They have 2 audits right now, which we're going to be going over, the CERTIC one, and they also have a fairy-proof audit. Exactly what you want to see from a project with 30 million market cap. All the ecosystems and DEXs that they are offering, including Radium, Joe, Solarbeam, PancakeSwap, SushiSwap, Ox, 1inch, QuickSwap, Pangolin, all the big ones that you can think of. And I love that they say Moonriver on here instead of Polkadot or anything like that, or Kusama, they just say straight Moonriver. Now, the Rubic Relay widget enables users to buy and sell tokens on any website, which means that your users can buy any token without having to leave the website. Now, at the moment, they're sitting on their one paper. They're going to be releasing their white paper soon. The problem that they're solving is that DeFi users waste hours and hundreds of dollars on fees to mitigate between blockchains, switching between DEXs, and using bridges. We all know this process is a fucking hassle. So this is looking to change the game for centralized exchanges and the way we trade crypto as a whole. Now, the DeFi market is obviously a massive market for them to take advantage of. Their major advantage is being able to house 8 blockchains, so you don't have to go and try to find a way and watch a video on how to send from Ethereum to Binance or Binance to Polygon. So just so you can get into each of those projects. Now you'll be able to just get access to everything off of one platform, which is fantastic. And with mass adoption looking forward, they are looking to integrate with more than 10 other blockchains like Mina, Casper, Cardano, Loopring, Xfin, Arbitrum. So they're looking to continue to expand. They have a long-term vision and goal. This is great. I'm a big fan of this project, and I'm happy to be able to bring this to you. Now, based on their CERTIC audit, they have a 96 score, which is fantastic. Their audit was from October 26th of this year. They only had 1 major centralized problem, which was resolved, and 3 minor code issues, which were also resolved. And the audited files that they went through were their swap contract, their offset recovery, and their full math system. Based on the safety and the market volatility, everything is looking fantastic. Now, keep in mind, again, this is a $30 million market cap. So a $3 billion market cap will be a 100x move for this project. And that's not too far-fetched considering what they're looking to aim at. Let's look at what MetaHero was able to do. And MetaHero was kind of similar to this with the audits and all these things going on in the back end, working with major ecosystems, so on and so forth. Now, this is a complementary project to all of these beasts. You know that when people start to hear about this and the multi-chains become very, very popular and chain agnostic becomes the next cool thing, these are going to be the ones that people start buying the fuck up. And that's not financial advice by any means. Do your own research, do your own diligence, make sure this is a good project for you. But in terms of what I'm seeing here personally, this is all great things for myself. And looking at this chart, you can see that we had a nice little move in September. This project has not been out very long. We had a move in September, we had a move in October. Now we're finally getting 3 days of green candles. These volume candles are starting to come in, similar to what we're seeing here with the volume pickup before the move started to really take off. You can even look right here before we started to see these massive volume candles, so you can still get in relatively early. We are doing a flipping right now on the EMAs, doing nice little crossover. So the 5 is going to be crossing over the 30, more than likely coming soon. That's going to be nice and bullish. To retest this at 80 cents is going to be more than a 2x move. And keep in mind that this is a $30 million market cap. So this project can easily do a 10x, 20x, 50x. Now you just have to be patient for those, and you got to wait for the catalyst, and hopefully that something in the market sparks a story or something where RBC will really take off. All it really takes for a project like this is their marketing team, just because of the project that they are and the companies that they're looking to work with. It's some next level shit. If you're looking to buy RBC, for example, you can get access to it on Uniswap, PancakeSwap. We were looking at Gate.io for the chart because they don't actually have the chart on TradingView yet. Or you can get it on Dodo, ZT. This is going to wrap up our video on RBC. Hopefully everyone's having a great morning, afternoon, or evening, depending on wherever you're watching this. If you didn't get a chance to already, make sure to go throw a like on our video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, go join our Discord or our premium crypto accelerator program, and we'll catch you on the next one.